Hello everyone, nice to meet you all around the world. I'm Zoya. Today we will launch a new product online. Thanks for attending this event and I hope all of you stay safe and healthy. As you see, Biomic is a full range of staining system which can provide quick solution for technicians. And the Biomic gum is specially developed for gum. It includes 6 kinds of pink stain to satisfy operating requirements. Sometimes I ask myself, why should technicians choose Biomic? First, one Biomic gum kit can satisfy external staining on any ceramic restoration, fast and cost saving. Biomic gum stain is a universal mixing case. Each bottle can be mixed with no limitation. Simple usage, the color from pink 1 to pink 5 gets dark, avoids confusion of color during operation. The Biomic gum kit completely simulates natural gum color, which contains one special wave color. Are you ready? Let's start.
Looks beautiful, very easy to handle, comes in various shades. So you can basically create your tissue area in ceramics without stacking porcelain. You don't have the problem of chipping, you don't have any other problems, and it looks really beautiful. Easy to learn, easy to apply, and like I said, it works on nearly every ceramic in the world. Firing temperatures are very low, and you will really love it. This material has just been introduced. We have been trying it since a few months. And you see, this is the kit, the Biomic kit. And the Biomic kit comes with a variation of different colors, pink colors, and stackable liquid ceramic, which is, it's really amazing.
Buonasera. Sono Alberto Santini, sono un odontotecnico italiano. Per questo Aidite ha fatto ancora di più e ha preparato anche il pink che nelle lavorazioni come le Toronto, dove vengono utilizzati gli effetti gengivali, possiamo utilizzarlo con molta facilità.
Hello, my name is Gabriel Tipulescu. I represent 3D Smart Dent from Romania. And have excellent results for the gingiva. This kit also can be used on any kind of restorations, okay? Even the buildup, but for monolithic solutions, it's excellent. You will have the perfect timing, the perfect colors for the gingiva. It's a fantastic solution, and we are very happy to have it.
Very stable material is exactly what I see after a spire. It's very predictable, very easy to use, and I think that is a material that is gonna help the 3D zirconia and also the Biomic stain kit that we have before. It complements it very well, and you guys are going to be able to get this to enjoy exactly what I'm enjoying in my restorations nowadays. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Masanori Toda. I'm a dental technician working in Tokyo, Japan. Now, I've been using Biomic for a while. This, the pink gum color. By using Biomic, the thin layer of the stain, you can create your ideal pink color. You can mix the pink and make the exactly pink what you want, or you could layer it, make a live looking tissue. Now, one part I like about Biomic is the temperature. It's not that high. Biomix pink color. I've been done several cases already and I just love it. Try it. I'm recommending you this. Bye.
Hello everyone. I'm Raul Quiremo, dental technician from Spain. Let me introduce new product of company Aidite, Bionic Stain Glaze. Bionic Stain Glaze Down. Universal stain can be used to desilicate and zirconia. Can even be stained without them discoloration due to low cooking temperature. It's also super easy to apply and reach the necessary color of the gum. Thank you for watching.
我叫李成宇，我觉得它非常接近人牙齿的颜色，所以在选择上不会非常困难。由于它的粘稠性，我可以跟其他的品牌颜色做混合，可以非常均匀的混合出我想要的特殊色系。它有一个非常鲜艳的红色，这个红色目前我在其他品牌是看不到的。整体它的颜色跟它的使用的逻辑都非常简单，非常好上手。
Hello, everybody. My name's Ian Fegan, and I'm from Sydney, Australia. I hope you're all well. Back on these cases, it's a pleasure to deal with products that are so high quality.
I'm Miss from Japan. It will be very smooth and nice surface. Other company and have to bake 3 times or 4 times needed. But Biomic can one big. Very different with other company. Very nice material.
It is the latest material in our dental part, and it is a liquidized ceramic stain material, and it is simple to use. It has all the color we need, and have no color we don't need, and the low temperature can save our time and save our money. It combines all the advantage from other products, and I think the Biomic is the only choice.
Hello, my dear friend. Welcome to Aidite's Biomic Gum Release Webinar for the American region. We have friends from US, Canada, Argentina, Mexico, Colombia, Chile. Thank you for taking the time to join us. 1 year ago, we released our Biomic Aesthetic Flowable Ceramic. It has changed the lives of thousands of technicians from across 80 countries. Today, we will formally release the Biomic Gum Flowable Ceramic for tissue, hoping it can bring more value to your daily work. Our Global Technical Director, Daniel Swami, will introduce Biomic Gum Flowable Ceramic, how it works, and why it is your best option for pink tissue. Please write your questions during the presentation. Daniel will answer at the end of the presentation. And at the end of the presentation, we have prizes for you. So now let's welcome our US General Manager, Thomas Houston, to disclose it to you. Thomas?
Good afternoon, everyone. And thank you for everyone for making the time for this excellent launch of our Biomic Pink Gum material. We're all very excited at Aidite USA to introduce this and to get it rolling out on the market today. First, I want to also introduce Robert Hadley. He is our new outside national sales manager for Aidite USA. Robert has vast knowledge in materials and CAD/CAM and really brings a lot of benefits to Aidite USA. Be sure to stay online and on the Zoom call at the end and write your answers into the question. We will be asking 2 questions at the end, Daniel. And with that, we will give away to the first 5 that reply through chat a Biomic Trial Pink Gum Trial Kit to each. So be sure to do that. And if anyone else wants to answer, please do, because we'll have additional gifts for everyone that types in a correct answer. Thank you all very much. I want to release this over now to our technical director, Daniel Swami. Thank you.
Dan, you may start.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. I just want to personally welcome you to this presentation, and I'm hoping that I can give you some good information that you can use in your labs and with your restorations. It is my great pleasure to actually launch this product, and I just wanted to thank everybody for the time. We really appreciate it. As I work with the scientists at Aidite, one thing that comes very clearly across to me is that they're very innovative and they listen to what types of products are going to be needed in the market. And if there's any challenges that we face, they're very quick to actually change it to make the products better. So Biomic in general, by the way, Aidite believes that we want to bring products to the market that was that is going to add much value to your organization. Okay, so it's for us, it's not just about a sale. It's about working together as a partner in this dental industry so that you can experience incredible value to your organization. So Biomic, generally speaking, is a flowable porcelain material. It can be used as a staining glaze with the F liquid that we're going to talk about. But in general, it is a flowable ceramic, and we need to make sure that we will get really good results in a very, very thin microstructure situation. Okay, so this is our new product release. It's called Biomic Gum. And a lot of innovations and a lot of research and development has gone into the Biomic products in general. So basically, the Biomic gum is a material that is able to replicate natural tissue. Okay, so my previous job as a lab owner and as a denturist, I saw a lot of patients with different colors of gums and different characterizations in denturist patients. I always used to wonder why we choose acrylics that were very general in color and very basic. So sort of one size fits all. But when it comes to actual replication of natural dentition, whether it's crown and bridge or implant supported bridges, we need to make sure that the gums are easily replicated with different effects. So if you look at keratinized tissue in a patient, generally speaking, you will have a lot of different colors that are present in the gum. Okay, so you can have vein structures, you can have dark areas, lighter areas. So if you look from the sulcus area, which is really light, okay, fairly light in the sulcus area by the cervicals, and then in the mucosa area, you have a little bit of darkness. And then towards the vestibule, you have really nice, deeper looking reddish or pink. So when we were developing this material, we made sure that all of these characterizations were could easily be reproduced. Also, a lot of times you have to have bony structures, you have to recreate the frenum areas, the vestibule areas. So a lot of these things needed to be done in order for a restoration to match the existing tissue. So the Biomics, I don't like to call it standard glaze, it's a flowable ceramic actually. You can actually mix and match a lot of these colors. We have six colors that are represented in the kit, okay? And then we have a pink R, which is generally used for mixing other colors or creating different hues and a little deeper chroma if you wanted to use a little deeper. So I just wanted to make sure that you understand that these are can be mixed and matched. Generally speaking, the pink R is used in restorations that have a really stained understructure or an intense colored in understructure. This is where the pink R will go. But keep in mind, in your hands, you can actually reproduce just about any colors or hues that you want for gums. Okay. So here you can see three different types of gums that are being introduced to you here. You can see in the first one, a lot of vein structure. And the second one is a lighter pink. And the third one to the right is fairly universal. Okay, here is here's the gum structures that were developed by a colleague of mine, Chang Min. He does really excellent work. And you can see even on the model, it looks really good. Notice how he's varied the colors, as we spoke about, from the sulcus to the mucosa. He varies these colors so it looks very, very natural. And it's not just one color, one traditional color, as you might see in a denture. So biomic flowable colors plus biomic gum tissue represents the entire biomic coloration system. So now we have a complete system with the biomic gum tissue material. So I always feel that for optimum results, Aidite recommends using the complete system of biomic, which includes the aesthetic kit as well as the biomic gum tissue. Now, certainly, you can use this material on lithium disilicate or metal restorations, PFM, such and so on and so forth. So it is actually universally used because it's a low fusing material. It fires anywhere from 1030 to 1040 degrees Celsius. Somebody says we
hello, Sam. Yeah, we cannot see the screen. Can you share the screen? Sorry. Can you try to share the screen?
Is that better, Fiona? Can you see me?
Not yet.
I think you need to enable me to see the screen. It says host participation screen sharing. Is it okay?
Okay.
Let me start over, please.
Sorry, guys. Oh, sorry about this.
Can you see the screen?
No. You're the host, but we cannot see the screen. You have to open the PowerPoint and then show it.
Again. So I'm sharing the screen now.
You shared it through the, you opened it through Zoom. Yes. Yeah, now we can see it. Great.
Can you remove the bottom part so I can get to my PowerPoint, please?
Okay.
Remove the bottom portion where everybody is located so I can get to my PowerPoint.
You can move it by your from your side. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can you see the screen now?
Yes, we can. Thank you.
Okay, I apologize for that. I'm gonna start from scratch. Welcome everybody. I just want to make sure that you know that our company wants to bring great value to you. So our scientists have developed this product. We have spent a lot of time. We want to bring great value to your organization. So any product that we introduce, we feel that it should work really well for you. My name is Daniel Swami. I'm the director of technology. So the biomic gum is a material that is a flowable ceramic, a flowable porcelain. I feel that this is going to revolutionize the way that you are going to create natural tissue. And I'm gonna go through the process of how you can do that. But just know that this is a flowable ceramic. Instead of, you can use it as a standing glaze, but really the entire biomic system is a flowable ceramic where you can do microfine layers. Okay, so this is a new product that we've come up with. By the way, our innovative staff of scientists and research and development people like to innovate new products almost every year. So this is our newest product, the gum tissue. Okay. The whole idea behind this material is that we are going to replicate natural tissue. Okay, so when you see an edentulous patient or a patient that has exposed gums or recession areas, you see all different kinds of colors in it. And so the idea for the six different shades that are represented in this kit, you will be able to use it very well to replicate natural dentition. So here's a picture of healthy tissue. This is keratinized tissue that you see in healthy adults or children. And when you look at a picture like this or in the mouth, you see all different kinds of colors, okay? So you don't just see one color, you see vein structure, okay? So and then by the sulcus area, you see lightness of colors. In the mucosa area, you see little more deeper colors. And then in the vestibule area, in the edges, you see a nice deeper color. So even if you are using, if you're doing an implant restored restoration where you need to replicate gum tissue to match the existing gum tissue, or crowns that have recession areas where the crown is very long and you need to mimic the gums to kind of make the 8 to 9 or 9 to 8 look good, you can easily do this with this material. So keep in mind when this product was developed, it was developed to make sure that you could replicate all of the different identifications and characterizations that come with natural tissue. So the biomics coloration system or the gum system, actually I don't like to call it stained glaze, it's a more of a flowable ceramic system, is composed of six different colors, 1 through 5, and a color called R. R is generally used for replication of deep areas or to cover areas that are already pre-colored. So if your understructure has a lot of color in it or is light and very opaque looking, then you can put a thin layer of this R material and then go ahead and do the rest of it using your 1 to 5. So here in this picture, you can see three different types of gum tissue. On the far left, you see a lot of keratinized areas, nice red areas in the vestibule area. And you can see that my colleague has done a very good job of replicating the frenum, okay? So, and then the second picture is a more lighter color. Some people have this tissue color. And then some people have a lot more deeper colors where you can add a little bit of purplish blue to it. One of the beauties of this system is that you can take some of the natural colors that are found in the aesthetic kit, like the purple and the blues, and you can add some of that to create your own variation of colors. So sometimes I used to see patients that have kind of a purplish look to it. You can certainly vary that color by adding a little bit of the colorations system that's found in the aesthetic kit. Here, my colleague has done a really good job, as you can see in the sulcus areas. He's got light configurations. You know, he's created the frenum areas, and he's definitely done a very good job of replicating the vein structures. Now, this is important if you have a patient that has a very high smile line. Okay, so if you are doing a implant restored restoration, that wherever the restoration ends and meets the gum tissue, it needs to be very ideal and homogeneous. So with our system, you can replicate just about any colors, any characterizations that you see in natural dentition. Biomic is a flowable color system. So now our system consists of the entire colors of the gum tissue as well as the aesthetic kit. So basically it's a one system that can be used for any types of restorations. So you can use this for zirconia restorations. You can use this for lithium disilicate as well as feldspathic ceramic or PFNs. So in areas where you are doing, let's just say a zirconia restoration and there's extreme recession, and you have to build this area in pink to match the adjacent dentition, you can very easily do this. So for optimum results, we recommend that you use this complete system of Biomic. So the coloration method consists of the Biomic aesthetic kit as well as the Biomic gum. So we feel that this will give you the best results possible. Certainly you can use other people's materials, but I think for the best optical results, where light refraction and light reflection is needed, you can use the Biomic coloration system, which consists of the aesthetic and the gum tissue. So in order to understand why we advocate this, and those of you that don't know our system, I'm going to play a very short video that will introduce the different colors we have so you can naturally color your teeth, your crown and bridge, and then use the gum system. So this is just a very quick introduction to our coloration system. Very quickly, I'm not going to spend too much time on this, but in order to color, I think the two go well together. If you color your restorations with the Biomic aesthetic kit, and we have a graph system that we use from high saturation colors to mid saturation, to warm areas and the incisal translucencies that you will mimic. Okay, so if you use this code and the coloration system, not only will your teeth look good, but also your tissue will look perfect. There's the high saturation, the warm colors, and the colder colors. And all these colors are represented in the aesthetic kit. Okay, so basically, this is just the kit itself that I use for coloration. That's another part of the presentation. If you wish to see this, please contact me and I can give you a personal presentation on the aesthetic kit. Okay. Within the aesthetic kit, you have all the different color guides that are represented from orange all the way to the blues, the whites, and there's a pink also there. By the way, you can really very easily replicate transitional areas as well as translucent areas with the blue one, blue two, and the black. Okay, so basically what we're doing with both systems is the fact that we're actually creating a very thin skin over the crown or the edentulous areas that you're gonna paint with pink. And this will give you a very nice 3D layered effect for a natural look. Okay? So here are some photographs and you can see that a lot of the characterizations, the pericamata lines, the lobes are really well represented in the crown and it hasn't been glossed over. So this is one of the beauties of the Biomic coloration system, is the fact that you're actually putting a very thin skin over it as opposed to building porcelain and then baking it, which tends to be very ineffective at times because you have to match the CTE of whatever your understructure is. Okay, so these are the results that have been created with the color system that we use for natural dentition. Okay. Whereas now the biomic system, the tissue colors is very innovative. We can create really beautiful aesthetics, not just on the teeth itself or the crown portion of it, but also now on the tissue portion of it. So just to give you an explanation of the technical portions of how biomic is created, we have very microfine particles of ceramics that are mixed with color grains and then embedded in a glaze medium. Okay, so this is the three-part situation that is the composition for biomic. Now, keep in mind, one of the reasons that we feel that this system is very ideal for replicating 3D teeth is the fact that we use rare earth elements instead of metal oxides. So your traditional stain and glaze that you may be using in your lab is composed of metal oxides. The difference between metal oxides and rare earth elements are two things. The rare earth elements are a little bit more expensive, predominantly found in China, and it does not block light when you look at it through a scanning electron microscope or when you do spectrophotometer studies. Metal oxides actually bounce light right back because it does not allow the particles to actually, light particles to penetrate through it. Okay, so the big differences between our system and others may be that we are using rare earth elements as opposed to metal oxides to color it. Okay, so if you look at the microstructure here, you can see how tightly bonded the particles are. This is only one micron, and you can see there's no voids or gaps, and therefore, the biomic system really gives you beautiful optical characteristics. If you have voids and areas that form bubbles, you have to constantly reglaze it or polish it. Whereas our biomic system is very consistent, it's very homogeneous. So when you put a layer on, you'll feel that this goes on very smoothly because the particle sizes is very, very small. So in the biomic system, as opposed to traditional stain and glaze, we use 6 to 12 micron particles. In your traditional stain and glaze, the particle size starts at about 20 microns. Okay, so again, you can replicate any type of coloration in the tissue with the six colors that are available. So the colors that you will see there are cream pink, natural pink, a purple pink, a dark pink, blood vessels that can be created with number 5. And then the sixth one is for application in areas that have a very opaque substructure. Okay, this will cover it because it's fairly intense. But as well as that, the sixth one can be used to create other modifications of colors. And then we have two 3D pastes. We have 3DN and 3DV. The 3DN is a neutral glaze paste. What this 3DN does is if you look at the bottle itself, you will notice that it has a slightly grayish tone to it, and this lowers the value. Okay, this is very useful for coloration of teeth itself, the crowns, but also for use as in the gum areas where you want to actually subdue the color and make it look a little bit lower value, this paste will do it. The 3DV paste is really good for changing the viscosity of the material, in other words, making it thinner or thick, and then actually building some structures onto it. So especially at the sulcus areas, if you wanted to identify this a little bit more, you can actually add a little bit of a thicker paste to it, and you'll be able to see that this will change the contours slightly. Okay? In the biomic coloration kit or the aesthetic kit, the 3DV is mixed in a thick viscosity. And those of you that have not experienced that, It's a beautiful system where you can actually add some proximal contacts or incisal areas all the way up to 0.5 millimeters. So instead of using a fix-up porcelain and doing additional fires, you can actually use this 3D paste with a glaze liquid tube and actually do a slight buildup if you have to. So all in all, this system represents a total material that can be used for coloration, and it really does not matter what type of material you're using. So again, you can create different shades if you wish. You can have multiple variations of shade just by mixing and matching. And if you wanted to dilute the colors, you can easily use the 3D V glaze or the 3D N glaze. Okay. So here you can see how the surface is prepared. You basically want to sandblast the surface. I would advocate that you color your restoration at the teeth part of it, the crown part of it, and then do the one or two glaze of the tissue. By the way, in your last process, you can actually manually polish the surface to a nice thin luster or a smooth luster. Okay? And here you can see the various things that the materials will do. So from the first pink to the last pink, pink one, starting from pink R to pink one, you can create these variations of colors. When you magnify this, again, you can see the natural effects of the color system. And if you wish, we can send you a schematic of how this material works. If you wanted to create different characterizations, this is available to you. For example, you will see that number one pink is a lot lighter than our pink, and you can use different methods, different coloration processes. And we'll show you the video towards the end. And I think that this will be very helpful to you. And here are some more pictures of ones that look very real. To the far right, you can see how the natural crown, actually the crown looks very natural, and you're able to actually insert this crown in the patient's mouth and the tissue just blends beautifully. Look at this picture here. It is extremely beautiful. These are all crowns that were made, individual restorations that were made, and then the tissue material was applied to it. So in an implant retained situation, this will look very, very beautiful in the mouth. And here's the schematics of what you would want to use: the mucosa area, the light areas, and the free gingiva where the sulcus is, and the various ways you can use this. So it's really good for you to experiment on your own. We can send you a 300 bridge that you can experiment with, where you don't have to mill something. And this way you can get really adept at using the colors and finding intensive areas and bone structures and things like that that can be replicated very easily. Okay, so this is just a schematic to show where the free gingiva is, the proximal areas, and how to actually color the restoration. Okay, I think we talked about the components of this kit. The two glazes that you can use. And now we're gonna get into the more traditional ways of doing things. So again, you can change the viscosity of it by using liquid one or liquid two. Okay? You can make it into a very flowable thin paste. If you did not want to use a very thick formation, you will just add the liquid to the material and make it into a very thin viscosity. Now, if you wanted to add structure to the gingiva, you can certainly do it by making it into a thicker viscosity. Okay, the high saturation, the hue, the warm areas, and the cold areas. We've talked a little bit about this. Again, this can be done with an aesthetic kit, but look at if you notice, the gingiva area is so nice, and that's been replicated with the material. One of the more important factors about staining material is that it is composed of A, B, C, and D. There's beautiful ones like terracotta, there's blues and mauves, and also black and blues that you can use to first color the crown portion of it and then use it in conjunction with the pink. Yeah, so here's some pictures of ones that have been done using a color range from deep red to light red. And here we are able to create a lot of different colors by mixing and matching. So you can be creative in your lab, and I believe that in your hands, you can make this product look very, very good. I believe that you guys are very experienced technicians and clinicians, and you can do this very easily in your lab just by playing around with this material. And the learning curve is very not steep at all. You'll get it the very first time that you use this material. Okay, there's a high number of restorations being done these days in our dental labs. A lot of people are doing all on four types of restorations. Traditional ones where they do basically full construction, a mass construction with mass material of zirconia, or you can do a frame design in zirconia and do individual restorations, which I advocate. And I'll talk to you a little bit about that in a little bit. So here is my preference of how to do all on four types of restorations. Here you have a traditional framework that's made out of zirconia, and then the thimble design or individual designs of restorations. So here is a traditional aesthetic way of doing it. You notice that you have to pre-color the white material, and sometimes it looks purplish, sometimes it looks bluish, and this is really not an exact science. And keeping this in mind, this is one of the reasons why biomic gum material was developed, so you wouldn't have to do this. So here you would have to add porcelain or build porcelain in order to color it reddish, and it is very tedious and a lot of work. So with the biomic tissue material, you're bypassing all this work. You are able to actually do the frame, do your individual restorations, and then place two layers of the biomic pink material, and then place your characterizations in it, and you're good to go. Okay. So traditionally speaking, this is another traditional method of doing it. So if you were to say that these were made out of 3D Pro, there would be the last thing you would do is cement the crowns, but you would actually fire your biomic tissue material on the frame structure itself. And the last process would be to cement the crowns in place. So basically what you're doing is you're not putting this whole mass of zirconia into the oven, which creates a lot of CTE problems and stresses. You have a very uniform thickness of a bar material made out of zirconia. You're actually using the biomic pink material to color it. And then the last process would be to polish it, and then place your individual restorations on it, and it is good to go. This is a surefire way of not creating stresses, excess stresses in your restoration. So the last thing you want is basically to have a material that is very thick, that goes in and out of your oven with multiple firings, and you develop a crack in it. That's the last thing you want. So this is another traditional way of doing the gums. You can see there's a lot of work involved. You need to layer a lot of porcelain on it. And there's expansion and contraction among this huge thick piece of material. And now you can do it without material and have a very thin layer. Okay, so a little bit more developed pictures of what you can see. You know, also you notice that if you were to place this in the mouth, there would be a color difference between the actual live tissue, the keratinized tissue, versus what you have created artificially. And traditionally speaking, you did not have very good coloration systems in the past. You had to build porcelain. Now you don't have to do that. You just add a micro thin layer of the biomic tissue material. Maybe do two bakes, and you can actually create very nice natural looks. Again, traditional gums, versus what you would do now with a biomic visit. There's a world of difference. And we also talked about this, the traditional way of doing this. This is my preference of doing individual restorations, but the bar material is already pre-stained with the pink or pre-colored with the pink. And then you would just cement 3D pearl material onto it as individual pearls. So the gum layer, here again, the traditional way of doing it is you layer a lot of porcelain, very thick amounts. You keep firing it until you get the right color. It may take anywhere from 3 to 5 bakes. And each time you're baking, you're getting diminishing results because you can actually form some microfractures into the material, which will give you a lot of headaches. So, you know, we kept all this in mind when we developed this material because we felt that the traditional way of colorations of gum and layering different amounts of porcelain is really not the ideal way to do it. So the thicker the porcelain, the more push and pull there is going to be, the more expansion and contraction there is going to be, and there's a good chance that you can crack this entire bridge. Yeah, traditionally, there's another layer, like I said, of material that needs to be put on there. But now we're bypassing this with our gum tissue material. So my point is that in the traditional way of doing things, was very tedious, very labor intensive, and now we can replicate natural dentition using a very thin microlayer. So the simple aesthetics for gums is what we call it now. You will achieve really good lifelike biomic results, whether it's an implant restoration or a crown and bridge situation where the tissue has been resorbed and you need to replicate the tissue. Okay, some more identifications of what you would use to color your crowns first. We can give you a schematics if you would like to use. And again, I advocate using the aesthetic system for coloration of your crowns and then using the pink material to color the gum areas. And this is what you will get as beautiful results. This was done by a colleague of mine and really, really does show the natural effects and the natural looks of the restoration itself. I think you've seen this video, but I'm just going to play it again one more time. Okay, so this is what the kit consists of. It's got a shade matcher. So if you're gonna look at the patient or have the dentist choose the shade, you can actually use the shade matcher to do this. Now, I would advocate that you fire different colors of pink and use your own schematics for this. So you can add portions of 1 to 4 or 1 to 3 and create your own shade guide because all the different keratinized gum tissue seems to be different, okay? So this is just a basic guide for you to use. You can certainly have your own schematics if you wish to do your own like this or just use ours. Yeah, this is done by one of our colleagues in the US. Look how beautifully he's created the tissue in the areas. That's the kit itself. And again, we talked about the viscosity control. This comes in 4-gram bottles. Right out the bat, if you mix it, you have a very nice viscosity. If you wanted a thick viscosity, you would dab some of the liquid that's in there and then create your own viscosity. If it's too thin, if it's too thick, then you would add either liquid one or liquid two. 4-gram bottles. is a really nicely done restoration by Lewis Sharp. He's a phenomenal technician from Las Vegas. He's done a beautiful, beautiful restoration. And this was his first time out with this material. So I can confidently tell you that right off the bat, if you try it, you are going to achieve a lot of success. Okay, so basically that's it. I always like to have people give a short quote of how the biomic system has been working for them. And if you would like to do that, we would be glad to accept your quote. And you can definitely achieve artistic excellence in restorations with our system. Aidite wants to stress the importance of a partnership. I like to always stress this because without a partnership, we don't benefit. We want to have a mutually benefiting partnership with you. So to create beautiful smiles and make people healthier and more beautiful, that is our logo. We would really definitely like to partner with you. And please do me a favor, please try this material because I think that it's going to make a big difference in your organization and you realize the value very, very quickly. Thank you so much for your patience and your time. I apologize for the delay initially, but Fiona is gonna take over.
Hi.
I'm gonna.